Hey guys! So, here's a video about how to do things in general.
Can we get a bit more specific?
A video about how to solve problems, potentially using code?
Fantastic!
The thing is, when you work in software development, especially game development, you sometimes need to solve problems that no one has ever solved, which is fun. That means that sometimes your only weapon is general problem solving, and we will give it to you. So the first step is easy, just have a problem.
Oh, I have plenty.
Let us pick one. Let's say we want to implement a platforming game. When we try to convince the computer to do it, it does not work well.
Build a platformer.
Computer says no.
To understand why, we need the most convincing visualization in the history of human existence. A tier list. In double S tier, we have the really abstract stuff, like do a thing. The reason the computer said no is because the abstraction level of our request is way up here in S tier. But machines are not the smartest ones. They operate in C tier if we are lucky. So this is where an instruction gets actionable for them. And even you will struggle to solve an S tier problem without splitting it up.
Are you sure? I'm pretty sure we have the smartest viewers on the whole internet.
Let me explain. When you ever had to write an essay and sat there in front of a blank sheet of paper, this is what went wrong. You clearly were willing to do the action, write essay. But write essay is not actionable without splitting it up. You need to do the chopping.
Please, teach us the chopping.
Getting down from S tier is mostly a question of actually defining your problem. Ask yourself, what do I even mean by that? In our case, what even is a platformer and what kind of platformer do I want to make? We might come to answers like, it is a video game where you can walk and jump. Oh, and I wanted to have some enemies. This is still rather incomplete and not actionable. But we are getting much closer. If you want to go down to the B tier, we have different options. We can go ahead and break things down if we can. This is great if it is possible. But realistically, this might take creativity and sweat and we might get stuck. Fortunately, our sub-problems are already small enough so we can communicate them to other people.
Yeah, it's always good to use other people's sweat instead of your own.
We even have a good chance for usable Google results. Honestly, that is the whole secret why computer scientists can Google basically everything. We have learned to break down the problem just a level and then Google the parts that are difficult. But let's go on with the platformer example. You would need to break down all of these things, but let us just do one for this video. We said we want a jump. We thought a bit and broke this down to move up, slow down, and move down eventually. We also did some Googling and came across coyote time, for example. We are almost there. This is almost actionable. If we had an intern, we could just leave it here, but most likely we do not.
Oh, here's your coffee.
Thank you. The part left to do is basically puzzling. We have a bunch of B-level tasks and a bunch of C-level instructions the computer can do. Now we want to put a bunch of instructions in the right order until they solve the B-level task. And this puzzle might not always be easy. Programming just is a complex task, generally speaking. We can bridge the gap by coming from both sides. We can build high abstraction level functions out of individual statements, and we can further refine our problems. An experienced programmer has gained an intuition for their building blocks at the bottom, but also ways to break down a complex problem. A good way to learn problem solving is to try and copy strategies from other people. This is what you should look for in a tutorial. You want to understand how they solved the problem. So what did they do to break it down into a few core tasks? What were these core tasks? How have they broken these down? And just then, how have they coded them out? You can even try and learn from us. We make a game ourselves, it's called Versifas Function. In it, we draw out every damage zone and every trajectory so we can unleash randomized chaos upon the player. We make devlog videos where we explain what we do. Also, here are things you might not know about the Godot game engine.